Hello friends, my name is Professor Sakshi Shah from Mechanical Department of Bhiurabhai Sawant College of Engineering, Narre, Pune. Today we are going to discuss a topic from Mechanical System Design. Now why this subject is introduced in your syllabus in BE is because you have already learned Design of Machine Elements 1 and 2 in 3rd year. In that you have learned how to design the different components like shafts, keys, couplings, gears, etc. So now in this BE you will learn the how to design the whole system. That's why its name is Mechanical System Design. So today we are going to discuss one system. It is called as Design of Conveyor Belt. So it is a part of material handling system. The basic function of material handling system is to pick the load, to convey it, means to carry it, and to unload it. These are the basic functions of material handling system. Now, with what objective we generally design the material handling system? These are the ideal qualities. It should be accurate in transporting load to the desired destination. Means there should not be any compromise in the quantity as well as quality of the load. Precision in picking the load. Then the load should be transported in scheduled time, because obviously time is a money. Then transporting loads of required quantity. It should transport the load without any damage to that component. Then automation with minimum power required. There should be low initial and operational cost, and it should be easy to maintain. Now, what are the conveyors? Conveyors are the group of devices used for moving load in horizontal or inclined direction along a fixed path in a continuous flow. Means the mass flow rate will be continuous, but it will be along a continuous path. So what are the advantages? The advantages are the conveyor system ensures the steady and sufficient supply of that material. By changing the speed of belt, we can change the speed of material, and it can be started and stopped within a shortest period of time. They can run without operator if proper automation system is provided, and it can transport material at extremely high rate also. The disadvantages of the material handling system is it can only transfer along a fixed path. Means we cannot design material handling system for flexible routes, especially conveyors, and it is unsuitable for heavy loads because it cannot sustain impact loading. Now, as such, there are in the conveyors find application in various large scale and medium scale industries such as mines, ports, thermal power plants, sugar factory, dairy products. So what are the different types of conveyor system? The first is flat belt conveyor. It consists of head pulley, tail pulley, which is connected by a continuous belt, as you can see in the figure. Next is trough belt conveyor. It is a modified type of flat belt conveyor where the idlers are provided. The shape of the flat belt is converted into trough shape. Because of that, means inclined shape is provided at both ends. Because of that, it can transfer bulk load also. As you can see, if we use flat belt instead of trough belt to convey coal, then at high speed, it may fall down. So instead of flat belt, you will use trough belt. Next is blanket belt conveyor. It consists of this feed belt which feeds the... This is blanket belt type conveyor. It consists of a feed belt conveyor which supplies the material. This is main belt conveyor system because it conveys the material with the help of auxiliary conveyor system. The direction of belt of auxiliary belt and main belt conveyor system is adjusted in a such a way that this material is supplied in upward direction. So next, woven wire belt. This is woven wire belt conveyor. consists of woven wire of metals. It is easy, it supplies easily the, this is woven wire type belt conveyor. It is a metallic woven wire. Since the water or air can be easily passed, it can be cooled down easily. Hence, it is used to supply a material at high temperature. Next is chain conveyors. It consists of head sprocket and tail sprocket, which is connected with the help of endless chain. Next is screw conveyors. As you can see over here, it is a threaded screw which rotates inside this container. Because of this type of screw conveyor, we can use this screw conveyor for conveying semi-solid. Now we will see the basic elements of belt conveyor system. So, as you can see in the figure, this is a complete belt conveyor system. So, here the one is shown over here. This is the endless belt. Then, this is head pulley and this is tail pulley. So, head and tail pulley is connected with the help of endless belt. Next is snub pulley. This is called snub pulley. The function of snub, so this is snub pulley. The basic function of snub pulley is, as you can see, it is increasing the lap angle of head pulley. So as the lap angle is increased, you know the formula T tight upon T slack is equal to e raised to mu theta. So because of that, when lap angle is increased over here, because the presence of snub pulley, the lap angle theta will increase and hence the T tight upon T slack ratio will increase. Next is the idlers. Idlers are used to support the belt. As you know, the distance between head and tail pulley is in several hundred meters. So, to support the belt for such a large distance, we use idlers. The idlers are of two types. One is carrying run idler, other is return run idler. The carrying run idler supports belt as well as material, whereas the return run idler only supports belt. Please remember this. Next is, as you can see in the figure, this is belt tensioning device. The basic function of belt tensioning device is to maintain the tension in the belt. So, in this belt tensioning device, to maintain the tension in belt, we are using it. And the various components are, this is belt pulley, these two are belt pulley, this is take-up pulley and this is counterweight. So, with the help of this is known as vertical take-up devices. So, this is belt tensioning device used to maintain the tension in the belt. Next is, this is belt cleaner device. This is used to clean the belt material and this is also internal belt cleaning device. Next, this is a belt hooper. With the help of this hooper, we supply material to the belt system. So, these are basic elements of belt conveyor system. Now, we will see the capacity of conveyor. Now, there are two types of conveyor, horizontal and inclined belt conveyor system. So, this is first capacity of horizontal belt. This is capacity of horizontal belt conveyor system. Q indicates the capacity in meter cube per second. This is C. C is surcharge factor. 0.9 into P. D is belt width. It should be substituted in meter. Next, 0.05 bracket square into V. V is the velocity of belt. So, we will get capacity of belt in meter cube per second. If we want in meter cube per hour, we have to multiply it by 3602. This is the volumetric capacity of belt. If we want mass flow rate, we have to multiply this volumetric capacity by density. We will get mass flow rate. This is for horizontal belt conveyor system. Next, if you want to select surcharge factor, standard table is given in design data book. From that, we can select the surcharge factor. Next is capacity of inclined belt conveyor. The only change is in the factor K. Instead of surcharge factor, it is flow ability factor. The other factors are same. Next is how to calculate the diameter of drive pulley. It is calculated by K1 into K2 into Z. So in capacity of conveyor, instead of surcharge factor, we use flow ability factor. That flow ability factor also we can choose according to inclination of the belt conveyor system. Next is, as you have seen, we have used various elements in the belt conveyor system, such as snub pulley, idlers, then belt tensioning devices, head pulley, tail pulley. Because of using these devices, they will offer frictional resistance to the belt. And if we don't consider this frictional resistance in the calculation of output power, then we will calculate wrong output power. Ultimately, we will select wrong motor to drive this belt. So we should consider the frictional resistance to select a correct value of motor power to drive this system. So first we will see one by one what are the frictional resistances. First is load due to lifting of material to some specific height. So it is calculated by, this is load resistance due to lifting of load. Then mm is the mass of material per unit length. Its unit is kg per meter, and mm into g into h. H is the height through which we want to lift the load, and it should be substituted in meter. Ultimately we will get this value in newton. Next is frictional resistance due to idlers. As I already explained, idlers are of two types: carrying run idler, return run idler. So carrying run, the frictional resistance due to carrying run idler will be different, and due to return run idler will be different. Why? Because the carrying run idler supports mass of belt and mass of material. So as you can see, this is mm and mb, mass of material, mass of belt plus mi into zc upon L into G into L, where mm is mass of material per unit length, mb is mass of belt per unit length, both in kg per meter, mi is mass of each idler, it will be in kg, zc will be number of idlers. As you know, the distance between head pulley and tail pulley is in several hundred meters. We use more idlers. So how many number of idlers we are using? That, and L is the length for which the carrying run idler is used, and FC is frictional coefficient. So this mm will be absent in frictional resistance due to return run idler, because return run idler only supports mass of belt. So next is frictional resistance due to pulley. It is given by FP is equal to epsilon into F1, where epsilon is frictional coefficient factor. Next is resistance at loading station. Resistance at loading station is given by FL is equal to M into V minus VR. As you know that the material which is getting loaded at different velocity, so it will be initial velocity of material which is dropping on the belt from the hopper. V will be velocity of belt. So this formula is calculated by Newton's second law of change in momentum motion. Next is frictional resistance at unloading station. It is given by 3.1 to 3.6 into mm. Mm is mass of material per unit length, and B is the width of the belt. Next is frictional resistance at cleaning station, because we are using cleaner to clean the belt. So it will offer the resistance. So it will be given by FCL is equal to KCL into G into B. Again, B is the width of belt in meter. KCL will be constant of cleaning device. Now we will see in practical how to use this formula over one conveyor layout.